Hello friends, welcome to Freshers Live. Today we are getting into weekly current affairs video. Here I will discuss all the important questions that may be asked from this week's current affairs and important facts related with each question. So watch the video very carefully and try to answer the question asked at the end of the video. You can download the PDF of the latest current affairs from the link provided in the description. You can also download the PDF from our website as well as Telegram groups. Also, you can find the link for the Hindi version of this video in the below given description box. The link for the Hindi current affairs is given there. Before moving forward, let's check the answer for the question asked in the last video. Who is the executive director of UNICEF? The correct answer is option D, Henrietta H. Ford. Now, let's begin our session for today. Here comes our question number 1. With which country did India recently sign 6 agreements including hydrography, health, passenger and cargo services by sea? The correct answer is option B, Maldives. During his visit to Maldives, Prime Minister Narendra Modi and the President Ibrahim Mohamed Solih of the Maldives signed 6 key agreements and substantive bilateral level talks in a number of key areas including defense and maritime. The 6 key agreements include cooperation in the field of hydrography, cooperation in the field of health, customs capacity building between the Central Board of Direct Tax and Customs of India and the Maldives Customs Service, the establishment of passenger and cargo services by sea, the National Center for Good Governance, Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances, and Maldives Civil Service Commission on Training and Capacity Building Program for Maldivian Civil Servants, sharing white shipping information between the Indian Navy and the Maldives National Defense Force. Prime Minister's visit to the Maldives reflects the importance India attaches to its neighborhood first policy. Heading to our question number 2. Who is conferred with Maldives' highest award, Nishan Izzuddin? The correct answer is option C, Sri Narendra Modi. Sri Narendra Modi is conferred with Maldives' highest award, Nishan Izzuddin. The main aim of the visit is to further cementing ties with Indian Ocean archipelago. Prime Minister Modi and President Solih held delegation-level talks as the two countries signed a slew of agreements to strengthen bilateral ties in a number of key areas, including defense. Relations between India and the Maldives after the sworn-in of President Abdullah Yameen. The imposition of restrictions on work visas for Indians and signing of a new free trade agreement with Beijing also did not go down well with New Delhi. Maldives is a key to its maritime Silk Road project in the Indian Ocean acquired Hambantota port in Sri Lanka and Djibouti in the Horn of Africa. Indian government offered the Maldives a line of credit $800 million and 3 important projects have already been identified and the project report preparation in underway. Water supply and sewage for 36 of the island are implemented. Another one is Adu Urban Development Center. Third project is the SME Development Financing Project. Heading to our question number 3. Which country has been suspended by the African Union as there are no civilian rule established in the country? The correct answer is option C, Sudan. The African Union's Peace and Security Council has suspended Sudan as there is no civilian rule established in the country. The decision was taken at the AU's Peace and Security Council meeting in Ethiopia's capital, Addis Ababa. This move by AU intensified global pressure on Sudan's new military leaders to stand down after witnessing world violence since Bashir's fall. AU said Sudan will be suspended until power was transferred to a civilian-led authority in the country. It also demanded to resolve an entrenched and bloody crisis. Now let me share a few more information about African Union. It was founded on 26th May 2011. It was launched on 9th July 2002. The chairman is Abdel Fattah el-Sisi. The political centers are Addis Ababa, Johannesburg. The member states are 55. African Union aims to achieve greater unity, cohesion, and solidarity between the African countries and African nations. Heading to our question number 4. Which of the following has been declared as a monument of a national importance by ASI? The correct answer is option D, Chowkandi Stupa. Chowkandi Stupa, an ancient Buddhist site located in Sarnath, Uttar Pradesh, has been declared as a monument and protected area of national importance by Archaeological Survey of India. Chowkandi Stupa is a lofty mound of brick whose square edific is surrounded by an octagonal tower. It was built to make the place where Lord Buddha met his first disciples as he travelled from Bodh Gaya to Sarnath. It is a terraced temple built during the Gupta period, that is 4th to 6th century. Govardhan, the son of Raja Todamal, gave the present shape of Chowkandi Stupa. He built an octagonal tower to commemorate the visit of Hamugyan, the great Mughal ruler. Archaeological Survey of India was formed on 1861, which is headquartered in New Delhi, India. It is the premier organization for the archaeological researches and protection of cultural heritage in India. It functions under the Ministry of Culture. ASI is responsible for the regulation of all archaeological activities in the country as per the provisions of the Ancient Monuments and Archaeological Sites and Remains Act 1958 and Antiquities and Art Treasure Act 1972. Questions related to this topic are: where is Chowkandi Stupa located? Who modified the stupa by building an octagonal tower to commemorate the visit of Humayun, the Mughal ruler? When was Archaeological Survey of India established? To know the answer, watch the full video. Moving to our question number 5. Which country topped the IMD World Competitiveness Ranking 2019? The correct answer is option B, Singapore. Swiss-based International Institute of Management Development World Competitiveness Ranking 2019 said Singapore has dethroned the US to become the most competitive economy in the world. Hong Kong stands second spot in the list. USA stands third, followed by Switzerland and UAE, and fourth and fifth respectively. Qatar entered the top 10. India ranked 43, one position higher compared to 2018. The ranking process considered a wide range of hard statistics such as gross domestic product, unemployment and government spending on health and education, as well as soft data from an executive opinion survey which covers other parameters such as social cohesion, globalization and corruption. Questions related to this topic are: Singapore topped the IMD World Competitiveness Ranking 2019. IMD stands for India ranked dash in the IMD World Competitiveness Ranking 2019. What are the top 5 countries in the IMD World Competitiveness Ranking 2019? Want to know the answer? Watch the full video. Here comes our next question. Who won the French Open 2019 title? The correct answer is option C, Rafael Nadal. World number 2 Rafael Nadal clinched the 12th French Open title in 15 years in men's single category held in Roland Garros Stadium, France. He defeated world number 4 Dominic Thiem in the men's single. The Spaniard won the match with scoreline of 6-4-3, 5-4-7, 6-4-1 and 6-4-1. The 33-year-old has now won 18 Grand Slam titles, 2 fewer than world number 3 Roger Federer. The champions of the 2019 French Open are in men's single Spain Rafael Nadal, in women's single Australia Ashleigh Barty, men's doubles Germany Kevin Kravitz and Germany Andreas Mies, in women's doubles Hungary Tamia Babos and France Kristina Mladenovic, in mixed doubles Chinese Tepai Latisha Chan and Croatia Ivan Dodig. The 2019 French Open was held from 26th May to 9th June. It is the 123rd edition. The category is Grand Slam Tournament. The prize money is 42.661 euro, and the surface is a clay surface held at Roland Garros Stadium, France. Questions related to this topic are: who won the French Open 2019 title in women's category? Who ranks world number one in men's single tennis game? To know the answer, watch the full video. Heading to our question number 7. Who is appointed as pro tem speaker of Lok Sabha? The correct answer is option C, Virendra Kumar. Virendra Kumar, a 7-time MP from Tikamgarh in Madhya Pradesh, chosen as the pro tem speaker of the 17th Lok Sabha. He was MOS in the Ministry of Women and Child Development. He was also in the Minority Affairs Ministry in the previous government. He is likely to be administered the oath of office at the Rashtrapati Bhavan on June 17, the day where newly elected Lok Sabha commences its first session. On the first 2 days, the new MPs will take the oath. The election for the Speaker will be on June 19. He was elected to the 11th Lok Sabha for the first time in 1996. He became a member of the Standing Committee on Labour and Welfare. He served as a member and chairman of various committees. He studied a PhD, started his political career in 1977. He became the convener of Akhil Bharatiya Vidyarthi Parishad, Sarga District, Madhya Pradesh. He served a prison sentence of 16 months under the Maintenance of Internal Security Act in protest against the imposition of emergency when he was associated with RSS. He was Minister of State in the previous Modi government. Important questions that may be asked from this news are: Virendra Kumar is dash Speaker of Lok Sabha. Who is the former Speaker of Lok Sabha? Type the answers in the comment box, and if you want to know the answer, watch the full video. Moving to our question number 8. Who is elected as the President of Kazakhstan? The correct answer is option C, Kasym-Jomart Tokayev. Kasym-Jomart Tokayev has sworn in as the President of Kazakhstan. He was the interim president and hand-picked successor of Nursultan Nazarbayev. He won the election, which was held on 9th June with 70.96% of the vote, which was contested against 6 government-approved candidates. Tokayev's presidency aims to continue Nazarbayev's policies aimed at improving the well-being of the people. He succeeded Nursultan Nazarbayev, who announced his resignation in March after 30 years in power. This is the first time Kazakhstan gets its new president since the collapse of the Soviet Union. Here are the important questions that may be asked from this article. Tokayev, who sworn in as president of Kazakhstan, succeeds dash. Who is the first president of Kazakhstan? Type the answer in the comment box, and if you want to know the answer, watch the full video. Heading to our question number 9. Mela Kheer Bhavani festival is celebrated in dash. The correct answer is option D, Jammu and Kashmir. Mela Kheer Bhavani festival was celebrated in Jammu and Kashmir at Zesht Ashtami. In 2019, the day fell on June 10. The devotees prayed at the famous Rangya Devi temple in Ganderbal district, Jammu and Kashmir. Zesht Ashtami is celebrated by Kashmiri pandits across the country and outside as the day marks commencing of annual pilgrimage. Mela Kheer Bhavani is one of the biggest religious functions of displaced community of Kashmir Pandits who were forcefully evicted from valley in 1990s by militants. The devotees carry rose petals, walk barefoot and offer tribute to goddess and offer milk and kheer at sacred spring. It is believed that the color of the spring which flows below the temple will indicate of the valley's well-being. Here are the important questions that may be asked from this article. When is the Mela Kheer Bhavani celebrated? Who celebrates the Mela Kheer Bhavani festival to mark commencing of annual pilgrimage? When was the Kashmiri Pandits forcefully evicted from Jammu and Kashmir Valley? Type the answer in the comment box, and if you want to know the answer, continue watching the video. Heading to our question number 10. DRDO tested HSTDV along with several technologies. What does HSTDV stand for? The correct answer is option B, Hypersonic Technology Demonstrator Vehicle. The project aims to scramjet engine. The HSTDV demonstrated the performance of a scramjet engine at an altitude of 15 km to 20 km. Scramjet technology is dual-use technology. It will have a multiple civilian application when developed successfully. It will also be available for long-range cruise missile. The combustion of fuel takes place in a chamber in the missile at supersonic speeds in scramjet technology. It can be used for launching satellites at low cost. The project aims to scramjet engine. The HSTDV demonstrated the performance of a scramjet engine at an altitude of 15 km to 20 km. Scramjet technology is dual-use technology. It will have multiple civilian applications when developed successfully. It will also be available for long-range cruise missile. The combustion of fuel takes place in a chamber in the missile at supersonic speeds in scramjet technology. It can be used for launching satellites at low cost. Heading to our question number 11. The committee under V.G. Kannan, which was set up by RBI, is to examine dash. The correct answer is option A, ATM charges and fees. The Reserve Bank of India has constituted a high-level six-member committee under RBI Chief Executive V.G. Kannan. The committee will examine ATM charges and fees by banks amid demand for reviewing the levies. There have been persistent demand to change automated teller machine charges and fees as its uses are growing significantly. The panel will review the existing structure and patterns of cost, charges and interchange fees for ATM transaction. The committee will also review the overall pattern of usage of ATMs by cardholders and assess the impact, if any, on charges and interchange fees. Besides, it will assess the entire gamut of cost in respect of the ATM ecosystem and make recommendations on the optimal charge or interchange fee structure and pattern. Moving to our question number 12. Which country ranked 113 in the end of childhood index? The correct answer is option A, India. According to the third end of childhood index global childhood report 2019, India ranked 113 in 176 countries with 769 score out of 1000. The index released on May 28, 2019 by Save the Children, a United Kingdom-based non-profit organization which works for child rights. The countries are decided on 8 parameters, namely child mortality, malnutrition, lack of education, child labor, early marriage, adolescent birth, displacement by conflict and child homicide. Scores were out of 1000. The country topped Singapore with a score of 989. 8 European countries figured among the top 10, South Korea at 10th position, last rank given to Central African Republic with 394. India ranked 4th and Bhutan ranked, Sri Lanka and China. The rate of child marriage reduced to 25%. The biggest score witnessed in Latvia and Estonia, both up 40 points from 927 to 967. And Lithuania with up to 39 points from 934 to 973. The top 10 countries in this end of childhood index are Singapore, Sweden, Finland, Norway, Slovenia, Germany, Ireland, Italy, South Korea and Belgium. Moving to our question number 13. Who is to be honored with humanitarian award by UNICEF? The correct answer is option B, Priyanka Chopra. Indian actress Priyanka Chopra with the Danny Kaye Humanitarian Award at the United Nations Child's Fund Snowflake Ball in the month of December. The event will be held on December 3 in New York. She is a UNICEF Goodwill Ambassador. She visited Ethiopia last month. She is known for her contribution to social causes. She will raise her voice for children's education, India to raise awareness against child welfare. She is also to improve the education, health and safety of girl child in India. Now let me share a few more informations about UNICEF. It is headquartered in New York, United States. The head is Henrietta H. Ford. It was founded on 11th December 1946 in New York, United States. The executive director is Henrietta H. Ford. Heading toward question number 14. Which company emerged as the most trusted brand in India in 2019 according to TRA Research Report 2019? The correct answer is option B, Dell. Dell emerged as the most trusted brand in India in 2019, according to the report of TRA Report 2019. Around 31% brand trust index difference from Dell, and auto brand Jeep attained a dramatic entry in the second spot. LIC and Amazon ranked on third and fourth spots. Apple and iPhone emerged as India's fifth most trusted brand. Samsung at sixth spot, and its is top among mobile phones. LG's television are the leader and occupied seventh position in the list. The eighth trusted brand rank is held by Aviva Life Insurance. Maruti Suzuki is at 9th position and is followed by the State Bank of India at 10th place. The study conducted across 16 Indian cities on 2,315 consumers aged between 21 and 50 years with a minimum annual income of Rs. 2.4 lakh. The categories with the maximum brands are food and beverages and fast-moving consumer goods, contributing to 26.8% of the total brands in the listings. Now let me share few more information about TRA. It was founded on February 2008. It is headquartered in New York, USA. The key people are Mark Lieberman, the CEO. Heading to our last question, question number 15. The government has reduced the rate of contribution by an employee towards ESI from 6.5% to dash. The correct answer is option B, 4%. Center has reduced the employers and employees contribution under the Employees State Insurance Act. It will be effective from July 1. ESI Act gives insured workers medical benefits among other facilities. The move aimed at benefiting 36 million insured persons and 1.3 million organizations. It will also formalize the informal workforce in India. It will expand the social security coverage and facilitate further enrollment of workers under the ESI scheme. The Ministry of Labour and Employment has reduced the total contribution towards ESI from 6.5% of an employee's wage to 4%. For the employer's share, cut reduced from 4.7% to 3.25%. And the employee's contribution lowered to 0.75% of wages from 1.75%. Okay friends, that's for today. Thanks for watching our video. If you find the information provided useful, please do like, share and subscribe our YouTube channel. Follow us regularly to stay updated on current affairs. Dear friends, are you looking for a job? End your search now. Visit fresherslive.com, the next generation of placement network. Register yourself today and get placed in top companies. Until then, this is Freshers Live signing out from Current Affairs video. Take care.